Two Saturdays ago, the ups and downs of a 10-year career as a prize fighter culminated for Caleb Truax. The Osseo native was crowned the new IBF World Super Middleweight Champion with a majority decision over James DeGale. Jason Melillo profiles Truax in this week's Sports Jam Spotlight.
On Sunday at Lupulin Brewing in Big Lake, the new super middleweight champion of the world celebrated with family and friends. Two Saturdays ago in London, Caleb Truax pulled off arguably the biggest upset of the year in professional boxing when he beat James DeGale for the IBF World Super Middleweight title.
Oh man, it's not going to get old, that's for sure. Everybody that's saying it to me, I always tell them to say it one more time. It's a great feeling, and a lot of hard work went into these last 14 years, basically, and now it's like the culmination of everything.
Going into the fight, Truax knew he couldn't outbox DeGale. The Brit was too slick, so Truax and his team focused on being aggressive and pressuring DeGale. That game plan worked perfectly.
As soon as the second round ended, I was clapping my hands and saying, that's what we need to do all night long. I came up to him, and a lot of times I'll give him a lot of technical instructions in the corner. This fight, I didn't really have to. I just had to keep him on the game plan.
Here comes Truax again. Good uppercut on the door. Big shot.
Second or third round, I was feeling real good about how it was going. And then the fifth round, obviously, is when I hurt him and banged him up real good. And after that, it was, you know, he slowed down, and my confidence went through the roof, and I just kept on rolling after that.
When Truax's name was announced as the new champion, you could see the emotion on his face.
And new IBF Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Caleb Truax!
And later in his dressing room, that emotion poured out.
I make fun of fighters sometimes when they start crying in the ring, but man, I couldn't help it. I was just about to start crying, and then I got into the back. And with all my team, you know, my coach Tom Halstead and Ron Leich and Tony Gregelko and Jim Marine, we're all in the back, just us in the dressing room, and I couldn't help but cry.
What made the victory even more special is the people around Truax. He's had the same trainers and promoters for his entire career, and that's rare in professional boxing.
It's important to me just because that's the kind of guy I am, pretty loyal, and I know that those guys have my best interests at heart, and I trust them. You know, like it's a game where you can get hurt seriously, or you know, whatever can happen, and those guys are looking out for my best interest, and I have no doubt in my mind, you know, they're not just trying to make a buck or throw me in there with the fight I'm not ready. Just awesome to be able to share that with them.
We all kind of grew up together and evolved from just starting out to being a world contender, to being a world challenger, to now being a world champion. I mean, it's a sensational journey.
Successful fighters have to be dedicated, resilient, tough, smart. Caleb Truax is all those things. In his career, Truax has scored easy victories and suffered hard losses. Through it all, he stayed focused, and now the kid from Osseo is a world champion. As always, he'll fight on for himself, for his team, for his family. Jason Melillo, CCX Sports.
Truax says his strength and conditioning coach Josh Hutton and all the trainers at Body Evolution Fitness in Maple Grove were invaluable in his preparation for the DeGale fight. Truax will likely defend his title this spring. The venue and opponent are yet to be determined. Congratulations to Caleb.